Right, I'm back. And I'm ready to get it popping. So now the cream should be hot enough, and we're gonna add the first patty to the skillet. Okay. And look, there we go, and there it is. So we really have a lot of room on the other side, so I'm not gonna make this patty too big. Patty number two. We're gonna turn this down a little back here, cause it's just nice and simmering back there. Oh my goodness, it looks so good. So now while that's frying, throw away our garbage. Now I'm just gonna come over here now, and we're gonna get the rice started. Yeah, this meal should not take very long at all. It really shouldn't. If you're in a hurry, you just got off work, you're tired, this would be one of the perfect things to cook. Let me tell you. So, let's get the rice started. Gonna use this pot here. Now to cook rice, you determine how much you're gonna cook, and that's about how much water you're gonna need. So to get this pot almost full of rice, I'll probably have to use a half a bag. So I'm just gonna put that there. I'm gonna put that on high, because what we're gonna do is boil the rice. So I'm gonna put a little salt in here. That's to keep the rice from sticking to the pot. Here's my rice. I have some blue ribbon brown rice. And brown rice is very healthy for you. So that's why I like brown rice. But sometimes different meals, white rice tastes better than brown rice. So basically you have to go with what you feel and what you think and your taste buds. Okay? Okay. Now, I will tell you this. When I make fried rice, it's always a plus to use brown rice. Always. Alrighty. So now it looks like our patties is ready to be turned. So we're just going to get over here and turn them. That's one. And then this is two. And there you go. And that's kind of what they look like when they're done. They look like that. Turn that down a little bit. Put this top on here with that water get going. And before you know it, we'll be done. Alright. So, it's coming near that time when we're gonna put the roast beef with gravy into the gravy. Now, usually when I make gravy, I'll put beef bouillon in there or two. Or I'll use the powder. But since this comes with a little juice gravy like, I'm just gonna put it right in there and make a bigger, thicker gravy, okay? So I don't know if you wanna take a look at that. It looks really delicious. So we're gonna use three cans. And they're kinda expensive, you know? $4 or $5 a can, but it's worth it, right? Because it's beef, it's real, and it's not no processed meat. So, you know, it's worth it. So now it's time for our patty to come out. I should have put some paper towels under that, but I didn't. So, further. And now we're gonna go with patty number 3 and patty number 4. And then it just becomes like the regular thing. You know, before you know it, you're just patting them and you're just putting them in and you're just taking them out. Before you know it, your pan's full and you're done and it's all over. Time to eat. There's one. Oh, this is gonna be a big one. Nice, nice. And like I said, they take their, kind of take their own shape. I'm sure if you took time out and you wanted to really shape it a certain way, you could make it round and you could do that. But I'm not really caring. Because once you bite it, it goes in the stomach, it's a good thing. And now as you notice, your grease is hot now, so they'll cook much faster, okay? So what we're gonna do, so we don't start burning the grease, is we're gonna get ready for the next batch. We're just gonna leave this like this, and we don't wanna leave it too long because it'll start getting hard, and we don't want that. But we do want it to cook. Yeah, so that could be a little darker, so I turned it a little too soon. Okay, so let's see how the water's doing. Oh, voila! It's boiling. So we're gonna get started on the rice. I don't quite think I'll need a whole half a bag of this. But what you wanna do is put the rice in and kind of fill up the bottom. Not too much of a big layer, but just enough. So there it is, and I used about half of the bag. And now we'll let it cook with the top off. Because if we put the top back on, it'll foam over and all of that and make one big mess, and we don't need that, right? Right. So back over here. Turn the bread again. Look at that. It's yummy already for your tummy. Yummy for your tummy. Oh yeah. So, like I was saying, it's really a fast meal. It could be really a good meal. Now what we want to check on the gravy is, we want to see, this one spoon I'm using. And then pull off. Using another one. So what we want to do is look at the vegetables. See, they're almost done. And that's a good thing. So we got that like that. And you know, we're just gonna have to cook a little bit longer before we add our roast beef. But it should be good soon. Okay? As you can see, the rice is boiling. These are ready to be taken out. Voila. And voila. Okay. So, we're going to go with our next batch. Let's see, coming right along. We're getting down through there, aren't we? Yeah, we are. We're going to be done before we know it. And it's going to be a quick, good meal. And then we can bust down. So, we put that in there. That one came out kind of round. Why not? To make this one kind of round too. Yeah, see there? You can kind of make whatever shape you want. I just kind of like to make all different shapes because sometimes kids, you know, they look at it and they think like they can picture it and make it into stuff like dinosaurs or whatever. And it's good for kids because kids then they'll eat it, you know. Yeah, they play with their food a little bit, but then they eat it, and it's all good, you know? Alrighty. The rice seems to be doing good. Yeah. That'll be done in no time. So, we're gonna get our next two ready. Because like I said, it don't take long now. And look at this, it's disappearing. We're getting on down through there. Got it popping. And that's what we want to do, keep it popping. Yeah. So. Oh, yeah. Yeah, like I said, this is a good meal to cook when you're getting off work, you're tired, and you just want to go in the house and relax. But you know, what your husband don't know won't hurt, okay? He'll probably think you spend all day, like, cooking a roast, you know, and making gravy, and you know, and all you did was simply open three cans and kind of added it with your own gravy and made it work. Thumbs up to that. You know, he'll appreciate that woman working in the kitchen hard as he's working. He'll really appreciate that. Looks yummy, yummy. And I don't know about you, but sometimes people like just a little burnt, you know, or a little thicker, darker color, you know, so that's not hurt. And it's not burnt, it's just dark. Okay? It's just dark. So. So we got it going here. And pretty soon we'll be doing the broccoli. And our meal will be finished. So now. I think we can add the, put that right there. I love those pots, how they just sit up by themselves all nice and goofy like that. I'm gonna start putting roast beef in now. Let it simmer a little bit like that. You can see the pepper is almost all the way done. And this one too as well. And that's a lot of gravy back there. Alright. So, I'm going to take can number one. Push it in there. Now to keep ourselves from getting burned, and I really shouldn't be doing this on the grease, but we're gonna put it like in one corner and kind of pile it up. And that way, after we get it all in, then we can stir it up. I'm ready to come out. Getting down through there. Okay, I believe so, they're so small. We could fit one more. What you think? Think so?
Yeah.
Of course we can. So, there it is. And it came out just like I wanted it to come out. Kind of long shaped. It'd be perfect right there on that side of the skillet. Perfect. As you can see, there it goes. Voila. Okay, now, as I said, it cooks awful fast now. You got your grease all nice and hot. So you really got to keep eye on it. So we're going to go to can number two. And we're going to still put it in this corner over here. Because we don't want it to pop. We don't want to get burnt. So we're just going to easily towel up this corner until we get it all in there. Juice in there to rinse it. Okay, and then we go to can number three. See how the color just changed? How it got darker? And then we're going to let that cook. Okay, and we're just going to turn it up just a little bit. Okay, now back to our bread. You can see our rice ain't quite ready, but it's getting there. So, what we'll do. Alright. So. Okay. These are ready. Time for them to come out. Uh-oh. Not quite time for that one. Okay, so now Get our next two patties ready. As you can see, you see how it's just leaving the bowl nice. Flour these up and get them in that skillet. Yeah. I've been making fried bread since I was 11. Long time. My dad taught me how. One of the best things he did for me, too, taught me how to cook. Because all the cooking I do, I learned from him and my grandmother. And as you cook fried bread, as you can see, your grease gets blacker and blacker, it gets darker and darker. So to keep it from burning, you need to control your fire. Sometimes you might have to turn it out up or turn it down just so it don't get too hot and start burning. Because all that extra flour lays on the bottom of the pan, and that's really what's like trying to get it to start burning. So. Oh yeah, gravy's gonna be great. All right, it's about time for us to start that broccoli. So, I have my special little gizmo here that I love so much. When I wanna steam my vegetables or whatever, I just get it and I just put them in there and throw them in the microwave. So, I need to put a little water in here for the steam. And then put that back. Put my broccoli in here. All in this thing looks so good. Let me put it. Okay, and I'm just gonna put a little seasoning. Let's see. I think our bread is ready to come out, and it is. This one is. Okay, this one's not quite ready yet. What we need to do is add a little grease, but I really don't want to do that since I only have 3 left, because it's just like a waste of grease. So what I'm going to do is just try to incorporate that and put the 3 in there together. And then I won't be needing any more grease. Okay, so we put seasoning salt, black pepper, let's put a little accent and a little garlic powder. And this should be done. Just a little bit. Okay. And I'm gonna stick this in the microwave. Okay. Stick this bread out. We can put our last ones in there. And dinner is almost done. Isn't that good? And if you want to make your patties thicker, just don't pat them down as thin. You know, you can get them thicker. Some people like them thicker. Like if they're done. Me, I like them in between. But oh, when they're real thin and crispy, they are so delicious. Let me tell you. Okay, so and yeah, I don't know if you guys are like me, but I don't really like a lot of rice. I like more meat and gravy on my rice. So when it comes to putting it on my plate, I really want to use that much. So right now we're just gonna rinse it. I don't know, some people have to use strainers, or if you prefer using a strainer, that's fine. But me, I just kind of rinse it like this. And basically that's how I do it. Okay, so now our rice is ready. We're gonna put that there, put the top on. broccoli now and the rest of our bread that we could use to grease with, but I don't want to waste grease. I'm just going to throw it out. But I'm sure that little grease will go on and cook that little bit, you know? So that's what we're aiming for. Nothing more, nothing less. So. All right. And it looks well. It's like it's all coming together and we're almost done. How good is that? All right, so. Sure, I don't need to wipe off, so I'm not going to put it up yet. Huh. I guess we can get rid of this. I'm not too sure, but I'm sure. Maybe we should do a test and see. Now what we want to see is how thick the gravy is. And the gravy's not really thick. Like those cans of meat was pretty greasy. So, we're probably going to have to add a little flour water to that to thicken it up. But that's okay. I'm sure it'll be just as good. Oh, look at that bread. Don't that look good? Okay, so what I'm going to do is take a little of this flour that we didn't use. And stir it up and I mixed it with some hot water. That's what you need to do to help dissolve the flour. So that's why we can use our cured water. I don't think that little bit hurt us, right?